Significant evidence has been discovered over the past 24 hours at the Avery Salvage Yard.
I found out from the media that there was possibly some remains found on the Avery property. There was a press conference that was on television, I believe it was November 9th, around 3 p.m., that was confirmed.
They feel that the evidence that they are that has been collected and that they are analyzing is that of human in nature.
Prior to that, I had no knowledge or reports given to me by police or detectives. I did keep some notes when things started with hearing things in the media, phone calls. So I did keep notes, dates, times. I called Officer Wiegert, Detective Wiegert, that evening of the 9th. And at that point, he told me they just overlooked calling me. And I told him I wanted to come out to the scene. They told me the scene was closed for the night. And I said, okay, you know, that's fine, but why didn't you give us some kind of report, some kind of a heads up as to what was going on? And then he commented to me at that time very rudely, well, I don't have to call or tell you about bones. And I said, oh, yes, you do. It's the law, it's the statute, 979. When there is a deceased body or remains that a coroner or medical examiner always notified, they handle the medical forensic side of the body. The next day in the morning, I was going to go out to the scene and I was called to a meeting by Sheriff Peterson. I thought, oh good, I'm finally getting a meeting. I'm finally going to get a update on what's going on and when I will be able to come out to the scene. But when I got there at that time, I was told I will not be going out to the case. I will not be going out to the scene. And if I do, I will be arrested. I loved my job. But I couldn't do it anymore. When was going to be the next threat of arrest, intimidation? I didn't feel safe going out on calls that night. So I had to end it.